The processional hymn is hymn number 315.
Testament reading is from officers shall speak further unto the people, and they shall say, What man is there that is fearful and faint-hearted? Let him go and return unto his house, lest his brethren's heart faint as well as his heart. And it shall be, when the officers have made an end of speaking unto the people, that they shall make captains of the armies to lead the deep. The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
Please rise. Declare the glory of God.
The firmament shows its standing order.
One day telleth another.
And one night certifieth another.
There is neither speech nor language.
But their voices are heard among them.
Their sound has gone out into all lands.
And their words are to the ends of the world.
In them hath he set a tabernacle for the sun.
Which is come forth as a bridegroom out of his chamber.
Part of the heaven, and runneth about unto the end of it again. The law of the Lord is an undefiled law, converting the soul.
The testimony of the Lord is sure, and he giveth wisdom to the simple.
The statutes of the Lord are right, and rejoice the heart.
The commandment of the Lord is pure, and giveth light unto the eyes.
The fear of the Lord is clean, and endureth forever.
Judgments of the Lord are true, righteous altogether.
More to be desired are they than gold, yea, than much fine gold.
Sweeter also than honey, and of the honeycomb.
Moreover, by them is thy servant taught.
And in the kingdom of the Lord there is great reward.
Who can tell how oft he offended?
Oh,
what is thou in promise of your faults? He also from presumptuous sins. Lest they get the dominion over me.
So shall I be in the midst of great repentance.
Let the words of my mouth and the meditation of my heart be always acceptable in thy sight.
O Lord, strengthen in my redeemer.
Glory be to the Father, the Son, and the Holy Ghost.
Was in the beginning, is now, and ever shall be, world without end. Amen.
Please be seated for the epistle. Marvel not, my brethren, if the world hates you. We know that we have passed from death unto life, because we love the brethren. He that loveth not his brother abideth in death. Whosoever hateth his brother is a murderer, and ye know that no murderer hath eternal life abiding in him. Hereby perceive we the love of God, because he laid down his life for us, and we ought to lay down our lives for the brethren. But whoso hath this world's good, seeth his brother have need, and shutteth up his bowels of compassion from him, how dwelleth the love of God in him? My little children, let us not love in word, neither in tongue, but in deed and in truth. And hereby we know that we are of the truth, and shall assure our hearts before him. For if our heart condemn us, God is greater than our heart, and knoweth all things. Beloved, if our heart condemn us not, then we have confidence toward God. Whatsoever we ask, we receive him, because we keep his commandments and do those things that are pleasing in his sight. And this is his commandment, that we should believe on the name of his Son, Jesus Christ, and love one another, as he gave us commandment. And he that keepeth his commandments dwelleth in him, and he in him. And hereby we know that he abideth in us, by the Spirit which he hath given us. Here endeth the epistle. Please rise for the gospel.
The gradual hymn is hymn number 279.
Amen. beginning of the 16th chapter.
Glory be to thee, O Lord.
A certain man made a great supper and bade many and sent his servants at supper time to say to them that were bidden, Come, for all things are now ready. And they all with one consent began to make excuse. The first said unto him, I have bought a piece of ground, and I need to go see it. I pray thee, ye have me excused. And another said, I have bought 5 yokes of oxen, and I go unto prove them. I pray thee, have me excused. And another, I have married a wife, and therefore I cannot come. So that servant came and showed his lord these things. The master of the house, being angry, said to his servants, Go quickly into the streets and lanes of the city, and bring in hither the poor and the maimed and the halt and the blind. And the servant of the Lord, the servant said, Lord, it is done as thou hast commanded, and yet there is room. And the Lord said unto the servant, Go out into the highways and hedges, and compel them to come in, that my house may be filled. For I say unto you, that none of these men which were bidden shall taste of my supper. The Gospel of our Lord.
Praise be to you, O Christ.
Thank you. June schedule, which means that today, after this service, we'll have our vestry meeting. No work day this month. We're giving everybody a couple of months off to recuperate and rest after all the hard work that was done this year. But we'll pick that back up when we get into the fall. Father is not here, Father Robert's not here with us today, but he is going to continue his class on Wednesday evening. So after the service on Wednesday evening in the Eucharist, he'll have his class, I think, for two more weeks. He also will continue to have the Veterans Breakfast, which will be at 9 o'clock on Saturday morning. Those of you who are interested in helping to serve that breakfast and honor our veterans are certainly welcome to please come and be part of that. We have our 4th of July Hymn Fest coming up. And that is on 6 o'clock on the 4th of July, which is a Sunday. We'll have a program of music and patriotic hymns. We'll have those of you that are interested in being the choir be part of that, and everybody to be singing along with us as well. So we will have rehearsals for those of you who are interested Thursday morning at 10 o'clock. If you can't make it at Thursday morning at 10 o'clock, you will be here at 9:30 the next 3 weeks to get anybody who would like to do it and can't get here on Thursday organized and rehearsed so they can be part of it as well. And then we'll have hamburgers and hot dogs after that so that everybody is well fed and in good patriotic fervor as they get ready to go off and watch their fireworks at the place that they choose. I'm going to continue our class between the services at 9 o'clock on Sunday mornings for the next 3 Sundays, it looks like. And we're going to be concluding the first epistle of the Blessed Apostle, St. John, as we go through that. Ladies at Lunch had a great lunch. Carolyn, what did you say about how many people moved in on the pictures of Ladies at Lunch? Over 200 people looked in on the Facebook pages to see the Ladies at Lunch. So, you know, it's really good that you're doing that and you have people's interest.
We're taking off the month of July, though.
Okay. Sounds good, because we have a lot of people traveling. I know that we do. For those of you that are visiting, a couple of quick things that we do that are in concession to the coronavirus. We won't pass the plate. The offering basin is over here on the left. If you want to leave an offering, you can do it after the service. And then communion will be in only one time, meaning we'll just do the bread for right now because we're trying to control the amount of interaction we have between people at close quarters for a little while longer, and then we'll go back to the regular process once this is finally and completely over with. Is there anything that I'm missing? Your sermon hymn this morning is number 566, Father Chapman.
Thank you. He knows there are those who would like to trap Jesus, to discredit him. While Jesus was being watched, he noticed that his guests at this dinner had jostled the position to pick out the places of honor at the table. Rather than keep quiet, Jesus addresses what he has seen. And as was often the case, Jesus expressed wisdom by telling a parable to convey a message. Now, what is a parable? We hear about parables often in the teachings of Jesus. A parable is a story that paints a picture to illustrate a point that is clear. Jesus takes advantage of this gathering to make another point. He tells another parable. Jesus catches the attention of everyone at the meal. With all eyes and ears on Jesus, he tells this parable. A certain man was preparing a great banquet and invited many guests. At the time of the banquet, the master sent a servant to tell all those who had been invited, "Come, for everything is now ready." Now it's quite possible that the owner of the house where Jesus was eating, as he told the story, had done exactly that himself. Typically back then, the verbal invitation went out. Initially, a verbal reply was given. And then, on the day of the servant, the day itself, the servant would go out to find and remind the guests that it was time to come. The guests would all be local, living within walking distance. And so this story is not only ringing true, but the guests around the table with Jesus and see themselves in the story. Jesus, the storyteller, is using a parable to teach. And now come the excuses from the invited guests in the story. But as we hear the excuses, we need to remember that almost certainly, a bit like sending out a wedding invitation today, the guests had previously accepted the invitation and replied to confirm that they were coming. But on this day, the great banquet had arrived. The servant had gone out to call the guests to the feast. And as he proceeded, excuses began flooding in. And as Jesus is telling this parable, he says that each and every person alike began to make excuses. Have you ever come up with a lamest of excuses to get out of something you had previously agreed to do? The true reason for rejecting the invitation is probably apparent to the person who invited you. Now, I can be wrong here, but I believe that there was more than an ironic hint of disrespect in the refusals. Excuse after excuse was received. Was it a coincidence that all of the invitees were rejecting the hospitality? Was it an outright slap in the face of the master? Once said, "I have just bought a field, and I must go and see it." Was there a reaction from Jesus' listeners around the table? Of course, some of the guests listening to Jesus were there to watch him closely, and they might well have wondered what the parable was leading to. Another says, "I've just bought 5 yoke of oxen," which is a small herd of cattle, "and I'm on my way to try them out." In other words, my latest business venture, or my latest toy, is far more important than this grand banquet that I'm supposed to be attending. Another invited guest says, "I have just been married, so I will be unable to come." Well, this is a most wonderful excuse. You have known for months that you were getting married. You've known for a while about your invitation to the great banquet. And finally, when the day arrives, you're going to use that as your excuse. All of these were lame excuses. They are also examples of things. Preferences, distractions, commitments, material belongings, occupations, and relationships that we ourselves might use as an excuse and as reasons to avoid what could be the most important things in life. The invitation which Jesus was referring to was the most important invitation that has ever been given to humanity. Jesus was revealing God's invitation to the world. Was there a reaction of unease from his listeners around the table? Jesus continued with the story. The servant reports back to his master, who becomes understandably angry when he hears that the entire guest list has decided to go off and do something else. He then orders his servant to go out into the streets and later into the country lanes nearby and until the house was full. The servant is commanded to bring in the poor, the crippled, the blind, Jesus Christ was inviting all of the Jews to follow his teachings, and they were rejecting his offer. He told them his invitation was now open to everyone, to the exclusion of all who had heard the invitation and rejected it. Jesus tells them, and I quote his words, "Then the master of the house, being angry, said to his servant, 'Go out quickly to the streets and lanes of the city and bring in hither the poor, the maimed, the halt, and the blind.'" Jesus is saying that invitation is open to all who will accept his teachings and follow his words. During the ministry of Jesus and throughout church history, the invitation has continued to be issued. God says, "Come," and many hear the invitation. It is an invitation to be in a relationship with the Maker of the universe. It's an invitation for sins to be forgiven. It's an invitation to enter into everything that God has in store for those who love him. What is your reaction to the invitation of God? You are invited to be in a relationship with him. You're invited to know a peace of mind that comes from forgiveness and having a guilty conscience.
most mercifully to accept our alms and oblations and to receive these our prayers, which we now offer unto thy divine majesty, beseeching thee to inspire continually the universal church with the spirit of truth, unity, and concord. Grant that all those who do confess thy holy name may agree in the truth of thy holy word and live in unity and godly love. We beseech thee also so to direct and dispose the hearts of all Christian rulers, that they may truly and impartially administer justice, for the punishment of wickedness and vice, and for the maintenance of thy true religion and virtue. Give grace, O Heavenly Father, to all bishops and other ministers, especially Bishops John and Juan, that they may both, by their life and doctrine, set forth thy true and lively word, and rightly and duly administer thy holy sacraments. To all thy people give thy heavenly grace, and especially to this congregation here present, that with meek heart and due reverence, they may hear and receive thy holy word, truly serving thee in holiness and righteousness all the days of their life. And who most humbly beseech thee of thy goodness, O Lord, to comfort and succor all those who in this transitory life are in trouble, sorrow, need, sickness, or any other adversity, especially Father Tim, Father Frank, Father Wiley, Michael, Eileen, Melody, John, Carrie, Carolyn, Jerry, Pat, Deborah, Bonnie, Sandy, Donna, Carrie, Don, Rita, Danielle, Grace, Jessica, Marie, Anne, Laura, David, Ariel, Julie, Stephen, for those who are on travel, especially Father Robert and Kathy, Gina and Ariana, Jacob, Judy, and Tom, and for those in the military, Jacob, Josh, Dean, Crystal, Karen, Julie, Kyle, Catherine, Kendall, Corey, Sage, Haley, Christine, Dominic, James, Johnny, and Andrew. We also bless thy holy name for all thy servants departed this life in thy faith and fear, especially Geraldine, Sarah, Charles, Diane, W.C., Pat, and Jim. Beseeching thee to grant them continual growth in thy love and service, to give us grace so to follow their good examples, that with them we may be partakers of thy heavenly kingdom. Grant this, O Father, for Jesus Christ's sake, our only mediator and advocate. Amen. You do truly and earnestly repent you of your sins, guard love and charity with your neighbor, and intend to lead a new life, following the commandments of God and walking from henceforth in his holy ways. Draw near with faith. Take this holy sacrament to your comfort. Make your humble confession unto Almighty God, meekly kneeling upon your knees. Almighty God, Father of our Lord Jesus Christ, maker of all things, judge of all men, we acknowledge that you weigh our manifold sins and wickedness, which we from time to time most grievously have committed, by thought, word, and deed, against thy divine majesty, provoking most justly thy wrath and indignation against us. We do earnestly repent, and are heartily sorry for these our misdemeanors. The remembrance of them is grievous unto us. The burden of them is intolerable. Have mercy upon us. Have mercy upon us, most merciful Father, for thy Son, our Lord Jesus Christ's sake. Forgive us all that is past, and grant that we may ever hereafter serve and please thee in this life. The honor and glory of thy name, through Jesus Christ our Lord. Amen. Almighty God, our Heavenly Father, who of his great mercy hath promised forgiveness of sins unto all those who with hearty repentance and true faith turn unto him, have mercy upon you, pardon and deliver you from all your sins, confirm and strengthen you in all goodness, and bring you to everlasting life, through Jesus Christ our Lord. Your comfortable words of Jesus Christ saith unto all who truly turn unto him, come unto me, all ye who travail and are heavy laden, and I will refresh you. So God loved the world that he gave his only begotten Son to the end, that all that believe in him should not perish, but have everlasting life. Hear also what St. Paul saith, this is a true saying and worthy of all men to be received, that Christ Jesus came into the world The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
Lift up your hearts.
Lift them up unto the Lord.
Let us give thanks unto our Lord God.
It is
very meet, right, and our bounden duty that we should at all times and in all places give thanks unto thee, O Lord, Holy Father, Almighty and Everlasting God. Therefore, with angels and archangels, with all the company of heaven, we laud and magnify thy glorious name, evermore praising thee and saying,
Holy, 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 Lord God, our Christ,
heaven and earth are full of thy glory. Glory be to thee, O Lord Most High. Blessed is he that cometh in the name of the Lord. Hosanna in the highest. All glory be to thee, Almighty God, our Heavenly Father, for that thou, with thy tender mercy, to give thine only Son, Jesus Christ, suffer death upon the cross for our redemption, who made there, by his one oblation of himself once offered, a full, perfect, and sufficient sacrifice, oblation, and satisfaction for the sins of the whole world. Did institute, and in his holy gospel command us to continue, perpetual memory of that his precious death and sacrifice until his coming again. In the night in which he was betrayed, he took bread. When he had given thanks, he break it, gave it to his disciples, saying, Take, eat, this is my body which is given for you. Do this in remembrance of me. Likewise, after supper, he took the cup, and when he had given thanks, he gave it to them, saying, Drink ye all of this, for this is my blood of the New Testament, which is shed for you and for many for the remission of sins. Do this as oft as ye shall drink it, in remembrance of me. Christ our Lord, by whom and with whom in the universe. Almighty and ever-living God, we most heartily thank thee that thou dost vouchsafe to feed us, who have duly received these holy mysteries, with the spiritual food of the most precious body and blood of thy Son, our Savior, Jesus Christ. Thus assure us thereby of thy favor and goodness towards us, and that we are very members of the corporate and mystical body of thy Son, which is the blessed company of all faithful people, and are also heirs through hope of thy everlasting kingdom by the merits of his most precious death and passion. And we humbly beseech thee, O Heavenly Father, so to assist us with thy grace, that we may continue in that holy fellowship, and do all such good works as thou hast prepared for us to walk in, through Jesus Christ our Lord, in whom with thee and the Holy Ghost be all honor and glory, world without end. Amen. Please stand and join me in saying the Gloria Excelsis. Glory be to God on high, and on earth peace, goodwill towards men. We praise thee, bless thee, we worship thee, we glorify thee, we give thanks to thee for thy great glory. O Lord God, heavenly King, God the Father Almighty, O Lord the only begotten Son, Jesus Christ, O Lord God, Lamb of God, Son of the Father, that takes away the sins of the world, have mercy upon us. Thou that takest away the sins of the world, receive our prayers. Thou that sittest at the right hand of God the Father, have mercy upon us. For thou only art holy, thou only art the Lord, thou only, O Christ, with the Holy Ghost, art most high in the glory of God the Father. Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with thy spirit.
Let us pray.
Peace of God, which passes all understanding, keep your hearts and minds in the knowledge and love of God, and of Jesus Christ, his Son, our Lord. And the blessing of God Almighty, the Father, and the Son, and the Holy Spirit be amongst you, and remain with you always.
Amen.
The Mass is ended. Go in peace to love and serve the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
Please rise. The recessional hymn is hymn number 489.